Hey, this is David of Inspect Canada. One very common deficiency that we find inside electrical panels are double tap breakers. Here I do have a breaker. Most breakers will only take one wire. There are some breakers out there that will take two wires, but that is not one of them. And the problem with that is really twofold, really. Since they're not designed for two wires, if you put two wires into it and you tighten up the screw, one of them will be tighter than the other, and the other one might be a little looser and it may start arcing. Poof, and then fire could start. Also, let's say you got two wires going into it, one's for the fridge and one's for the microwave, for example. Now you're adding a lot of power into this circuit, so it could overheat. But in most cases, sometimes they just put a doorbell low voltage wire into it. So people are like, well, it's never gonna trip the breaker, but that's not where the problem lies. The problem is that the breaker is supposed to only take one wire. So if there was an electrical inspection on this, it would not pass. But to be fair, double tap breakers is so commonly done, and electrician does it all the time. We do a lot of inspection and we see that very often, and to tell you the truth, I've never seen an instance where it created a problem. I know that it's not proper and I don't want to tell you it's no big deal, because if a fire starts in there because of it, that would just be terrible. But just so you know, most of the time what we do is we recommend the client that if they're gonna get an electrician inside their home to do anything else, just get them to fix this at the same time. Most of the time it's not worth it to pay $200-$300 for 1 hour of electrician work to come and do a 2 minutes job in there just to replace a breaker. Really, all we need to do here is to open this up, take that the breaker with the double tap out, take the wires out of it, throw one into this one and one into the other one. We do have another four spaces here. The reason they didn't do it is just because they wanted to save a little bit of money. So a breaker like this is roughly about $40. So now you're really exchanging a little bit of money into a fire hazard. So for the $40, totally worth it to just throw a new breaker in there, do it right. So when you sell this place, nobody's gonna complain about it. So give me a second, I'm gonna open this panel and then I'll show you exactly where the double tap is. So right here, as you can see, there's two wires. There's a red one right here and two black ones getting inside this breaker right there. That's where the problem is. So what we'll do is we'll take one of these wires and then we'll put a breaker right at the bottom right here. We'll hook it up in there and that'll be pretty much mission accomplished. Now, what's very important whenever you work with any electrical system is to shut the power off. This panel here does not have a main shut off on it. We are in a strata building here. So we've spoken with the caretaker. We're gonna go into the electrical room and we're gonna shut the breaker right there. You know, we're trying to make things right here. Nobody wants to hurt themselves. So it's a little extra step, but it's a very important one. So give me a couple minutes. I'm gonna go and shut the power off. It will get a little bit darker in here. We'll be working in the dark for a little bit, but we'll try to make the best of it. All right, now that I have the power off, I'll be able to take this breaker out of there, pull the wire, put the new breaker in, and get this done too, so it's set up properly. But the first thing I wanna do is, even though I did shut the power off, I wanna double check here. I mean, why take the chance, right? So I got a little sniffer right here. I can go on the wiring, absolutely no beeping. There's absolutely no power inside this panel. This is gonna be a lot safer for me to do. But keep in mind that if you're not comfortable around electricity, this is a very simple little how to do it yourself, but get an electrician to do it. If you're not comfortable, there's absolutely you know, no reason to get hurt here. And it would really only cost you a couple $100. All right, so let me get to this. So right now I'm gonna go and turn the power back on. We're gonna make sure that everything is working properly and that everything's in good working order. Then I'm gonna close this panel and we're gonna conclude this little video. All right, all I need to do right now is to put the panel back on and that'll be pretty much mission accomplished. So just give me a second, I'll put this on. So as you can see, replacing a double tap breaker is not very difficult. You know, it is very important that you do have some extra room in the panel. If we did not have this extra room, you either need to upgrade your panel or install a sub panel beside it. And that's often what happens when it gets filled up. People start double tapping it. But right here, this was just a lazy case of someone who wanted to save about $40 in exchange for a fire hazard. So right now, it took us approximately maybe half an hour. And you just save yourself $200 to $300. So it's incredible. So if you have any questions whatsoever about anything, please feel free to reach out to us. We'll be happy to help in any way we can. Until then, please be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the little bell. We really want to show you all the videos that we're coming up with. And you know, thank you so much for watching. We're so grateful that you took the time to watch this video. And again, if you have any question, reach out to me. Until next time, have a beautiful day.